So welcome back to the channel guys, hope you guys are fine and safe. Now as we promised, we are back with another video. Now we have decided to start a new series which we are going to name as How to Take Your Videos to the Next Level. Now, in this series we are going to talk about certain tips and tricks which we have picked up over the last few years and which we are going to share with you so that you can also make better videos. Now in the very first episode of How to Take Your Videos to the Next Level, we are going to talk about something called sound designing. Now if you go and search on YouTube what is sound designing, you will find a lot of tutorials and also other videos on it. But the problem with them is they are pretty long and we don't have so much time. So in this video, we are going to try and explain what is sound designing in the simplest way possible and also in the shortest amount of time. So let's first start with what is sound designing. Now, sound designing is nothing but adding some ambient sounds and also other sound effects in post-production. Now, just as smell is an important constituent of taste, sound is almost 50% of our viewing experience, and we should in no way be compromising on sound. So in order to better understand what is sound designing and also how it's done, let's jump into the computer. So here you can see we have our window open. We are currently using Sony Vegas Pro, but you can use any software of your choice. The layout is almost going to look the same. Now this is the timeline, this is how it looks like after sound designing has been done. These are the different layers which we have used. Now let's zoom in and let's see what we have done here. Now my first tip to you guys will be, first edit your video with the music which you have chosen. Now for the purpose of this video, we are going to use the intro clip of S-Frame Creations, and we are going to show you how we did the sound designing for this small sequence of 30 seconds. Let's first hear how it sounds like without sound designing. So as you can see, it kind of sounds nice only. But it somewhere lacks the life or the dimension in it. We can bring it to life by adding different sounds. Now once you start sound designing, the first thing you need to do is you need to go through the sequence which you have at hand. Go through it and see what kind of shots you have in it. For example, if we go through this sequence, we have a shot of a lamp with some greenery in the background. We have a farmer, a person sitting in a marketplace, and so on. Now think as if you were standing at this place and imagine what kind of sounds you could hear if you were standing here. For example, if you were standing here, since there's some greenery in the background, there might have been some sound of some birds, maybe some people talking. For example, in this one, since it's a marketplace, there will be a lot of commotion. So once you know that, you can start searching for your sound. The question arises is, where will you get these sounds? Now there are three ways in which you can find these sounds. Firstly, you can either record these ambient sounds while shooting. But for that you will need either an expensive mic like a Zoom H1 or something equivalent to it. Now the second way is you can sign up for a subscription website which has all the different kinds of sound effects. And the third way is, and the easiest one, is to find it on YouTube. Now, if you are a beginner, don't look for sounds at a paid website where you need to pay some subscription. Look for all the sounds on YouTube. You will find all of them, but you need to give credit to the creators of those music. Now, once you have got those music elements or those transition sounds, place them exactly below the video clip. For example, let us see how it sounds like when we put the sounds of some birds below that clip. It immediately sounds a lot more interesting. Now in this way you can add some transition sounds. Find those transition sounds and put them exactly below where you have the transition. Now this is the transition sound here. Now similarly, find out those sounds for your different clips. Now let us focus on this region only. There are 4 or 5 clips in between this. Now this is going to be our primary layer. So So as you can see that it already sounds very different and it already sounds much better. Now comes my second tip. Don't just use one layer of sound for a video clip. Use multiple layers. Now if we unmute the other layers and we go down, you will see that under that same clip, we have all these sounds. So how it helps is, it helps in bringing a kind of continuity in the clip. Now if we play the entire thing together with all the layers of sound below it, let's see how does it sound like now. You can clearly see or hear the difference. The different layers of sound, each adding some element to this, makes it complete. And that is what you need to do. You need to add different layers, as many layers as possible. But obviously don't overdo it. Keep it simple, but at the same time, make it interesting. Now we come to a scenario where you don't know what kind of sound you need to use. For example, in this scene, we could have used the sound of some birds, but that would have been a repetition. Now in these kinds of scenes where you don't know what kind of sound to use exactly, you can use your imagination. So you can do a little bit of experimentation and come up with some alternative. For this one, we put a bass drop and let's see how does it sound like. So this in itself is not going to make the difference. You need to hear the entire thing together. So as you can see that in these cases, you can use absolutely any sound which you want. You can even edit these sounds. You can put a resonant filter on it, or you can put a low pass filter on it. Now in the same way, build up the different layers of your audio and make it sound complete. Now with that, we come to the third tip, that is balance. Try to bring about a balance between the different layers of audio which you are using. Don't make it sound too loud or too faint. It should not stand out on its own. It should sound as if the entire thing is in sync. Now let's play the entire audio clip after sound designing has been done. Let's see how it sounds like. So you can clearly notice the difference which sound designing has brought to this. This entire thing sounds completely different now. Now in sound designing, the possibilities are endless. You can do anything and everything, but make sure that you don't overdo it. And that is the key to making your video stand out from the others. So with that, we come to the end of this episode. We hope that you learned something new today and it will probably help you in making better videos. With that, thank you so much for watching. Hope you liked it. If you did, kindly hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel if you haven't. We will be back next week with another video. Till then, stay tuned, stay safe, and meet you guys on the next video.